Yeah, well, no doubt about it. This was a very difficult childbirth. The last votes in the legislature came just before 6 o'clock this morning after a arduous all-night session. We just left the governor's office. He heaped praise on legislative leaders and lawmakers for their work in getting this bill, this package of bills, finally passed. The governor was effusive in his praise and said this is a very important day for California's future. Let's listen.
I'm so excited that finally my vision is one step closer to becoming a reality, which is to fix our water infrastructure. This is without any doubt the most comprehensive water infrastructure package that was passed here at 6 o'clock in the morning, the greatest package and most comprehensive in the history of California.
And you heard the governor say he is very anxious to sign that package of bills again after a very long and difficult ordeal. You may recall earlier this year, the governor actually held hundreds of bills hostage because he said it was so important that he get some kind of a water deal. That hostage deadline did not work, but now the bills are headed for the governor's desk. And one of the authors in that package of bills is Senator Joe Simitian of Palo Alto. Senator, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
One of the things that you wanted to do was see better oversight of the Delta. The governor said today that the package actually authorizes the construction of a peripheral canal, obviously very controversial. That was not my understanding.
No, I think that's a bit of an overstatement in a moment of euphoria. Look, before we can start talking about other ways to move water around the Delta, the first question we have to ask ourselves is how much water does the Delta need? Taking care of the Delta is job one. The legislation that's been passed and that the governor's indicated he'll sign says let's take care of the Delta first and foremost. But while we're taking care of the Delta, let's keep as a co-equal goal the need for water for a state of 38 million folks. Neither one of those two things can trump the other.
It was very difficult to reach a balanced agreement given all the competing interests involved here. What would you say to those critics who still say this was not good for Northern California, that it weakens water rights and could increase water costs here in the Sacramento area?
I've lived in Northern California and been a Northern California representative my whole life. This is a place where I think all of us are understandably a little bit anxious that what we like to think of as our water might go somewhere else. I wouldn't have been an author, let alone voted for the bills, if I hadn't been pretty comfortable with the fact that we're going to take care of Northern California and do that as part of a larger state. And I think that's what the public wants us to do. I think they want us to act as one state. Yes, we represent our districts, but I think people want us to put aside our regional differences and get the job done for the state of California.
All right. Senator Simitian, thank you very much.
Long night.
Let you get some rest.
Thanks so much.
All right. So once again, this is just the beginning because voters in California next year will have to be persuaded to pass this $11 billion package, this bond package for all of these changes to go into effect. Live at the state capitol, Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.